Hi there. 13.2 is all about volume of pyramids and cones. Take out your notes, slide this into your table of contents, and get ready for some high quality note-taking experiences. So first, recall the volume of a prism was the area of one base times the height of the prism. Likewise, the volume of a cylinder, this is just review, is pi r squared times height. Well, for pyramids and cones, the volume is just one-third of their sort of related prisms and cylinders. So a pyramid is one-third times the area of one base times the height of the pyramid. Now remember, height of the pyramid is that distance from the apex or the tippy top to the base. And likewise, the volume of a cone, one-third pi r squared times height. So, for example, if we were to find the volume of this square pyramid, we're using the volume is one-third base times height formula. We know, since we've got a square base, that b is 36 square units. And then the height, well, to find the height, which is the purple segment, AG, we're going to use the triangle made up of points A, G, and E. Segment GE is the apothem, and so with a square, if you double up the apothem, you have one full side length. So half of a side length is 3, and so the apothem, GE, is 3 units long. We're given AE, the green length, is 5 units, and so the apothem can be found using, sorry, not the apothem, but the height can be found using the Pythagorean theorem. So now we have all we need to know. Volume is 1/3 times 36 times 4, which is 48 cubic units of fun. How about this thing? We want to find the volume of that cone. And remember, volume of a cone is 1/3 pi r squared h. So volume, if you sub in those values, volume is 1/3 times pi times 1.5 squared times 8. Now notice 1.5 squared is 2.25, and I can multiply in any order I want. So I'll multiply 1/3 times 2.25 times 8, and that gives me 6. I'll tack on the pi at the end to give me a final answer of 6 pi cubic units. Here's another example. We want to find the exact volume of a regular hexagonal pyramid, the height of 8, and a base edge of 10. We know we're dealing with the volume formula, 1/3 area of the base times the height. We're given the height of the prism, so that's nothing we need to find, we already know it. We do need to find, however, the area of the base. Now we're given one base edge. Now since all of the base edges are 10, if I split up one base edge, I get 5. And then remember, with hexagons, that little half triangle is a 30, 60, 90. And so the apothem here is 5 root 3. And so the base area is 150 root 3. And now I have everything I need to find the volume of the pyramid. So volume is 1/3 times base, which is 150 root 3. Times height, which is 8. And so I can multiply in any order I choose. I'm going to multiply 1/3 times 150 times 8 first, and then I'll tack on that root 3 at the end. So I have an exact volume of 400 root 3 cubic units. Another example here, we want to find the volume of a regular triangular pyramid, the base edge of 12, and a height of 10. So the height isn't shown, but we do know that h equals 10, and we need to find the area of one base, given one base edge is 12. So, since we have a regular triangle, that's another way of saying an equilateral triangle, the area of the base, we can use side squared root 3 over 4 to get a base area of 36 root 3, and so we substitute those values into the volume formula. 1/3 times 36 root 3 times 10, which gives us a volume of 120 root 3 cubic units. Here we want the approximate volume of this regular pentagonal pyramid. The apothem is 3, the slant height is 5. So again, we're using the volume as 1/3 base times height formula. And we need to find the base area. Remember, the base is a regular pentagon. The apothem is 3, and so using trigonometry, we can find half of one side length, which means if I double that up and multiply by 5, I'll get a perimeter of about 21.796. I'll use that perimeter then to find the area of the base. Then I need to find the height of the pyramid. Now I'll find that height using that right triangle that's made up of the apothem, height, and slant height. Pythagorean theorem says that the height of this pyramid must be 4. And so therefore I sub in the base area I found, I sub in the height that I found, and we get a volume of 43.6 cubic units. Next, hey, let's pretend a cone has a volume of 480 pi cubic units. Its height is 10. How big is its radius? Well, we know we're dealing with this formula because we've got a cone. Then we know the volume and we know the height. We need to solve for radius. So, well, I see both sides of the equation have pi, so I'll divide by pi. I've got that pesky 1/3, so I'll multiply both sides of the equation by 3, and then I'll divide by 10. And so then I get r squared is 144, which means the radius must be 12 units. I need the volume of this thing. Now, you'll probably recall that we once found the surface area of this thing, and it was a little bit tedious to find the surface area. Well, finding the volume is a little bit more straightforward, because all we need to do is find the volume of the prism and the volume of the pyramid, add them together. So prism, of course, is base times height. Pyramid is 1/3 base times height, but the heights of the prism and the pyramid are different. So I'll add in little subscripts, H1 and H2. First, I know the area of the base is just 10 squared, easy enough. The H1, which is the height of the prism, is 14. Now, the height of the pyramid is going to be a little bit trickier. So I want to find that length. And so I'll make myself a right triangle using the radius of the square, the lateral edge, which is 13, and then the height. So once again, we need the lateral edge. We need to find the radius of the base. So the radius of the base, if the base is 10, using special right triangles, I know that the radius is 5 root 2. And so now we can find the height of the pyramid using the good old Pythagorean theorem. And so now we have all the information we need for our calculation. For this one, since approximation is okay, I'm going to pull out the calculator, and I get about 1,763.6 cubic yards. All right, last example. We want the exact volume of this thing. What is this thing? Well, this thing is a cone and another cone stuck together. They have the same circular base, but that circular base is kind of smushed together. So we've got cone plus other cone.
I'll use blue to represent the cone on the left and green for the cone on the right. So I know I've got 1/3 pi r squared h plus 1/3 pi r squared h. The radius in both of these cones is the same. It's 3, but the heights are different. So I have blue height, green height. The blue height on the left is just given to us. It's 4. The green height is unknown. However, because we've got a right triangle made up of the radius, height, and slant height, and that 30-degree angle, I know that the height of that cone off to the right is 3 root 3. And now, since we want an exact volume, we're going to keep our pi, we're going to keep our root 3 as much as possible. So I've got 1/3 pi r squared h plus 1/3 pi r squared h. And I know I can multiply in any order I choose, so I'm going to leave the pi at the end. I'm also going to leave the root 3 at the end. So 1/3 9 times 4 is 1/3 of 36, which is 12 pi. And 1/3 times 9 times 3 is 9, so we'd have 9 root 3 pi. And strange as it seems, that is our final answer, if we want an exact answer. Hey, thanks for watching, guys.